PowerDirector 16, let's make a hyperzoom from one clip to another. And that's where we kind of zoom real quick and boom, go into another clip, which is a really, really cool effect. So let's make a hyperzoom in PowerDirector 16. I've actually had a couple people, more than one, believe it or not, ask me how to do this. And I played around with this for a while to figure this out. So I'm going to drag a video clip down in here. And that's not very clear. So I'm going to take it there. I'm going to cut that out so it gets a little bit clearer. Move it back. And we'll take the sound out to make this somewhat easier. Okay, so we'll take some video here. We'll take a look at what we want, you know, and how we want it to look. And then I guess I'll go from when he's going to jump on the frame, like maybe right about there. So I'll take that out, and I got one piece cut, okay? So then I'm going to go, I'm going to do my zoom on probably 10 frames. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, right there. And then I'm going to cut that. I'm going to move this out of my way. And I'm going to expand this a little bit so I can see what's going on a little better. And this is the part that I want to kind of zoom in and out of, type of deal. I'm going to zoom into probably this video here. So again, unlink the sound. So what I'm going to want first is the fade effect. And I'm going to go into transition room. Okay? The one with the lightning bolt just underneath the T. And I'm going to go in here and grab the fade. And I'm going to drop it on my two videos in the center. Now I'm going to click it. And I'm going to go to modify. It's set at 10 seconds, which is good there. And then I'm going to do an overlap, which is good there. So right now what I've got is we're going from that bird to that dog. You see that? And all that is a quick fade effect, nothing more. So what we're going to do to really give it the effect of the hyper zoom, make sure you click on the clip itself. I'm then going to go into tools and power tools. We're going to do a crop and a crop zoom. So now here's how I determine what I want to do here. I can let this go through. Okay, and then I can add a keyframe. Zoom it in. I could put it on the bird if I want. Bring it down some more. I could put another keyframe. Zooming on even a little bit more, maybe on its head up there. And then say, okay. So I've done a zoom, and I've done a fade. So let's see what that looks like. Zoom, see how fast that went? So let's do the whole thing now. Bird's jumping around. Give me that zoom effect now, come on. Don't let me down. Zoom, see that? But let's add a little bit more, okay? Let's add one more thing. I'm going to go to FX, the effects room. And I'm going to go for some backlit. Yeah, we'll add some backlit to it. And I'll put that right where it's going to happen. And I need to pull this down all the way down to here. And line it up somewhat. Okay. So now I've got a little bit more effect here. Okay. Give me that video. And give me that zoom. Little zoom with the twilight zone. From the blue jay to the doggy. Zoom. See that? Now notice I had a bit of, yeah, kind of like a pause there. You see that? So maybe I should take my backlit and bring it down just a little bit more. Maybe I had too much backlit. Let's try it again. Give me the hyperzoom.
Zoom.
See that? So you could play with this. I mean, literally, you could play with this quite a bit. And you can get that hyperzoom look by really messing with this. You can make it more than 10 seconds or of what you want to do. Now, I could take this maybe just a little bit more. A little bit more of the backlit. Let's see how it looks now. So you're getting that hyper zoom or hyper zoom out effect. And really, the whole trick to this is when you're actually going into your tools and your power tools into your crop zoom. This is where the whole effect is. I mean, you don't even need this keyframe. I could take that keyframe out and only have this one and move it down. I'll take that one out too for now. You know, and we could go the opposite way. I mean, I could take this first keyframe, bring it in super tight. Really doesn't matter where I put it because it's so quick. And then add another keyframe and bring this keyframe, you know, out pretty quick. So I'm getting an in-out deal. And then hit say okay on that. And then let's see how that looks. So maybe the hyperzoom will look a little bit better where it goes into out instead of out to in. Boom, see that? So you get that hyperzoom effect. And again, you're doing it with three things here. Okay, you're going to cut the section you want to work in, and you want to work in probably nothing more than 10 seconds, 5 seconds. You'd have to play with that. And then you want to add your fade transition, okay, which is in your transition room. And then in the FX room, we added some backlight down here. So basically, you're working on the three things there. And that's how I would do a hyperzoom in PowerDirector 16. So pretty amazing. And like always, guys, if you'd like me to give your channel a shout-out, send me a private message, and I'll drop it in the back of one of my tutorials. Here is an interesting fellow. His name is Moody Prepper. We don't know who he is. He's wearing a mask. We don't have any idea. He's actually an amazing cook, and he has some cool ideas. If you're in the prepping and this interests you, you might want to head on over to Moody Prepper and sub up with him. And like always, guys, I'll catch you on the next one.